Hello, welcome to another foundation class with MathMassoft. My name is Mr. Legend and I'm your tutor. Today I'll be discussing multiplication of signs, and this is very important in mathematics, most especially when you are dealing with expansion of either linear equations or of higher power like polynomial. You have to understand how your signs actually behave when they have multiplication sign in between them. And the signs that we are emphasizing on here is your addition and your subtraction signs. Let's look at the summary of multiplication of signs. First, let me explain to you that in mathematics, it is good that you avoid signs to be written side by side. Anytime a sign is coming beside another sign, it's good that you separate either of them with brackets. So here I have minus times minus, because this minus without this bracket will just be standing side by side with this multiplication. So for me to be orderly, I'm just putting the bracket to separate it, so that it will be easy for anybody that wants to read it. Mistakenly, without your bracket, you may write something like this, and the examiner may be seeing something like this, may not understand that what you are writing is minus times another sign. So it's always good in the culture that you put bracket to separate signs. So I have minus times minus. This will give me plus, okay? Anytime minus multiply another minus is going to give me plus. And when I have what? Plus times plus, plus will be the answer. If I have minus times plus, it's going to give me minus. And if I have plus times minus, it's going to give me minus. Like I did for you when I was explaining like terms, here also I've helped you with summary of what you must always remember, that when you multiply same signs, the answer will be plus, and when you multiply different signs, the answer will be minus. Let's go back to the summary. Here, minus times minus, minus minus, same sign. So when they multiply, it's going to give me plus. Plus times plus, same sign, plus and plus. So that will also give me plus. Minus times plus, different signs. Different signs will only give me minus. And I have plus times minus, different signs also will only give me minus. This is the summary of what you must always remember. And it's very easy. Don't forget, even under like terms, I explain this. When two numbers of different signs, either plus and minus, when you are to combine them, definitely you will check the difference. You will subtract it. But when they are of the same signs, either plus 2, plus 2, or you have minus 2, minus 2, you will see that you will have to add them together. So when you have same sign, it will result to plus when they multiply, same sign when they multiply plus, different sign when they multiply minus, different sign when they multiply minus. Now let's combine this with numbers and see how it plays out. Now here you can see I have minus 3 times plus 4. Here you can see that I did not put this minus 3 into bracket, because minus is not actually standing side by side with multiplication sign. 3 has already separated them, so it is read minus 3 times plus 4. But because without this bracket, this plus will be standing with this minus, with this multiplication sign rather, I just use bracket to separate it. Don't worry yourself with this, it's just for you to be orderly. It's not something that may result to any penalty or so. It's just because when you are writing, you may, you know, mistakenly write these two joined together, and that may communicate something different to the examiner. So for you to be orderly, just put the bracket to separate them. So now, the first thing is that I have to multiply the sign before I multiply the number. So like times, don't forget, this times this. So the sign here will multiply the sign here, the number here will multiply the number here. So I'll first do minus times plus. They are of different sign, multiplying each other, it will be minus. Or let me bring you back to this place, minus times plus minus. You can see that. Then I will do 3 times 4, that will give me 12. Okay, I hope you are getting that and you are finding it easy. Here also, I have minus 4 times 5. Don't forget, I've told you that when you see a number that is carrying no sign, you should know that what there is what plus sign there. It is just invisible to you because it's not joining number together. So if you have ordinary 5, the sign in front of that 5 is plus. So indirectly, what we are saying here is minus times plus, minus times plus. They are of different sign, okay? And that will give me minus 4 times 5 will give me 20. Also here, you can see there is no sign written here, but I know it's plus 4. The sign is not just, it's not just written there. So it's plus 4 plus times minus will give me minus different sign, because they are different signs, result to minus, pardon me. And then I have what? 4 times 4, that will be 16. Also here, I have minus 5 times minus 2. Minus times minus, that's same sign multiplying each other, that will give me plus. And then 5 times 2, that will give me 10. And here also, plus times plus, this will give me plus, because same sign multiply. When same sign multiply each other, it will give me plus. 2 times 6, that will give me 12. If you find this video helpful, do share with people around you. Let them also gain from this knowledge and get it right when it comes to foundation in mathematics. You can check in the comment section to lay your hands on the assessment that I've put there for you, so that you can test your knowledge in this area and be sure that you have gotten this correctly. My name is Mr. Legend, and I'm always here to help you get through foundation in mathematics, even to the level of writing your examination and coming out with excellent results. See you in the next class. Bye.